We're coming into the end of the year, and that means that it's holiday season, and that means, whoop, boop, it's gift-giving season. Now, if you've ever tried to buy Christmas gifts or holiday gifts for the garden creator in your life, you know that they're notoriously difficult to buy for. I don't need anything. Well, I understand that, but nonetheless, I want to be able to give you something. So, if you're in that situation, here are five gift ideas for the garden creator in your life. Ready? Here we go. Gift idea number one, the new Sunset Western Garden Book. This is one of the best go-to resources. I use this constantly, and so it's a must-have for the bookshelf of any garden creator. It has a very detailed plant library of plants that are common in the nursery trade and includes detailed information and pictures about each of the plants and many of the common cultivars. It has information about the overall species that has a bunch of different cultivars and you want to know more about the overall species. It has these great background pieces of information. It also includes in some sections, you know, how to grow this particular type of plant. And then you go down to the back, and they have this wonderful section at the back called Gardening from Start to Finish. This is a great starter resource if you are wanting to get grounded in some good information for just getting started. It has all sorts of great topics like how to grow annuals and bulbs or lawn grasses, how to grow native plants or perennials or succulents, wildflowers or veggie gardening. So a lot of really great information at the back of that book. Toward the front, there's a whole series of plant recommendations for specific problems. So like this one is deer-resistant plants, plants that generally the deer don't bother as much. And then the key number one reason that I think this is a fantastic book to have on your shelf is that it has the Sunset Western Garden Zones. Now, you may be familiar with USDA plant zones. And just for background, the USDA zones are based on average annual minimum mean temperature. Now, what that means is what is on average the coldest that it will get in any year. So if you have plants that can survive cold up to a certain point and then beyond that they'll die, the USDA zones are really useful for figuring out what will likely make it through the winter and what won't. The sunset zones take it to a whole different level. They look at hot and cold, but they also look at rainy season and dry season and how those relate to the hot and cold seasons. They factor in things like wind and humidity and growing season, both the main growing season and the shoulder seasons on either side. And even in the desert, they talk about the space in between, the season when it's so hot that the plants actually shut down because it's too hot for them to grow. So they have these wonderful climate maps that are very detailed that help you understand the microclimates. So you look at a place like California, where I live, you know, it's a very tall state and with wildly different topography over all of it. And so, you know, we have really high highs and really low lows and high latitudes and low latitudes. So we have garden zones that go all the way from 1A up in the northeast of the state all the way down to zone 24 down in San Diego, with wildly different plant communities in these different zones. And now you may be outside of the Western United States, so the maps don't necessarily show your area, but they also include these great descriptions of their characterization of the zones. So you could look at your particular area and compare those with the descriptions that they have of the zones, hot and cold, rainy and dry, windy, humid, and what your growing season is, and find what sunset zone matches up with your local climate, and then be able to look at the plant recommendations and see what would be applicable to your setting. So this is an incredible resource. I use it constantly and highly recommend. This is the new Sunset Western Garden Book was released in 2012. It's in its 9th edition. So that is the current one. It looks like this. I like it so much that I even have two because I use it so much. And so it's just a great book. All right. Garden gift idea number two, good tools. Good tools are essential for any gardener or garden creator. Simply put, they make tasks easier, which saves time and makes it a lot more fun to be out creating your garden or maintaining the garden. So I have these pair of clippers from Corona Tools. I highly recommend them. Clearly, I've had them for a while. They've seen a lot of good use and they've held up really well. So highly recommended. But we're going to take this one step further. I want to show you this holiday gift guide that I found from Joe Gardner. Now, if you're not familiar with Joe Gardner, you should definitely check out his stuff. He's the host of Growing a Greener World. You can find those episodes on YouTube. And he also has the Joe Gardner podcast. And they have a great website. They offer some courses, a lot of tremendous information. Highly recommend that you follow his stuff if you really want to understand how to garden effectively. They've put out a holiday gift guide. You can go on the website right now and sign up for it. And it has a lot of good recommendations. But the key one that I found in the garden gift guide for this year is this dual holster. It's a leather holster that holds not only your garden clippers, but also a soil knife, which has a good trowel blade with a serrated edge so you can cut through tough fibrous roots if you need to. And it has markings for depth so that you can get your bulbs planted at exactly the depth that you need to for optimum growth. So, a great gift idea from Joe Gardner. Lots of other great recommendations on that list. I highly suggest that you sign up for his emails and that you download that list and check it out. Garden gift idea number 3, the whole seed catalog. With this name, they really aren't kidding. This gorgeous printed physical catalog from Baker Creek Heirloom Seed Company features the largest collection of heirloom seed varieties available in the US. It features seeds both from the Americas and from around the rest of the world. And the catalog has beautiful color photographs, entertaining anecdotes. It has recipe ideas for the different plants that you can grow, and it also includes the history of some of the different plant varieties and where they come from and how they've developed over time. Now, this catalog costs about $13. You can also order a free catalog from Baker Creek, but this catalog includes everything. And it's a wonderful way to have this great resource to dream and imagine what you might be able to do in your own garden if you choose to make a kitchen garden as part of your garden outdoor living space. So I highly encourage this as a gift idea because it enables that dreaming and imagining of what's possible. Now, you know who else was really interested in seeds, seed collection, distribution, and testing out of new varieties? The founding fathers of the US. And that brings us to gift idea number 4, Founding Gardeners by Andrea Wulf. This is a book about the revolutionary generation, nature, and the shaping of the American nation. And frankly, it's how history ought to be written. Brilliantly and thoroughly researched with a compellingly written narrative, it brings together the lives and personalities of the founding fathers through their stories and letters and the context of the times that they were in. It showcases and argues in a brilliant way how important gardens were to the founding and creation of the American nation. The founding fathers did not have a unified set of opinions on things. They had wildly divergent opinions and deep-seated disagreements about how the nation should be structured and what it should focus on. The thing that held them together, as is compellingly argued in this book, is gardening and their love of gardens and their understanding of the importance of plant varieties and seeds to the strategic success and economic success of the young nation. Now, another thing that brought these men together, as is outlined in this book, is their understanding of the importance of the health of the soils of the nation. And that brings us to our last gift idea. Gift idea number 5, a Kiss the Ground movie night. If you want to share something educational, inspiring, well-produced, and frankly, just fascinating, this is a wonderful opportunity. This movie is all about the health of the soil and how that can help us lead better lives, solve some of the biggest problems that we face in terms of the food supply and sequestering carbon, and offers real hope and opportunities for the future. So I absolutely love this movie. I recently had a chance to sit down and watch it with my wife, and we just thought it was really well done and offered a ton of great information. Now, best yet, if you go to the Kiss the Ground website, one of the ways to make it available is to just rent it for $1 on Vimeo. If you have Netflix, you already have access to it. So as the founding fathers of the U.S. knew, the health of the soil is integral to the health of the nation. And this movie talks about how we can preserve and regenerate the soils around us. I have to give a shout out here to Cynthia Soska from Serenity Warriors, helping people become more beneficial humans. And she pointed me to this movie. I really enjoyed it, and I think it offers some very compelling solutions to some big problems. So there you have it, 5 gift ideas for the garden creator in your life. The new Sunset Western Garden book as a vital resource for any garden creator, a good set of tools to help make gardening and garden creation easier, the whole seed catalog to inspire ideas of what you could grow in the garden, and also just a great resource for interesting information and recipes for edible plants. Founding Gardeners by Andrea Wulf to inspire a connection to the history of gardens in the U.S., and last and perhaps easiest, a Kiss the Ground movie night to share education, inspiration, and hope for solving big problems through regenerating the soils so that we can improve our health, improve our economy, and address climate change in a meaningful way. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Did you find these gift ideas helpful? Which one did you like best and why? Are you looking for gift ideas to share with others or looking for something special for someone in your life? Who are you buying for? Let me know in the comments. Of course, if you would like to help others find this information, please like the video so that Google will know to share it more. And feel free to subscribe to the channel. It doesn't cost anything. It just lets you know when new videos are available. With that, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.